writers of 1 Peter and Paul in Ephesians says something very interesting. He says that Jesus is a living stone who was rejected by man, and he became the chief cornerstone, and he made his living stones through Christ Jesus. I hold in my hand three stones. Some stones are big and fat and long and round. Some stones are small and smooth. Some stones have rough edges on them. He uses the analogy of building a house that glorifies God out of stones. It would be easier to build a house out of block, which are all the same size, the same dimension, and the same texture, or a house out of brick, which would be all the same color, all the same size. You might have to cut one in a quarter, one and a half, but it's still the same brick, the same size, the same dimension. When you talk about stones, and do you know how stones are put together? By knocking edges off of them and the rough pieces off of them until they fit together by color and by size and by shape. But here's what I want to tell you is this, is I can begin to stack block right here pretty high without even mortar or concrete. If you're going to build something out of stone, it has to have a foundation and a mortar which with the stone sets in. God's going to build a church with people who like country music, rock music, jazz music, people that like it cold, people that like it hot, people that like it soft, people that like it loud, people that like it long, people that like it short. God has chosen us, and we are to love one another as Christ Jesus loved us. And these stones are not to throw at one another. They're to build his house, to build his kingdom on the revelation of who he is through relationship with one another, through people that we don't necessarily like the same things or appreciate the same things. But when we work together in unity and love, we're bringing glory to our Father who loved us and gave himself for us.